Hi friends, in this video let's talk about some important SSRS interview questions with answers. So these are all the list of questions which is asked by the panel in the recent days. So I have covered a couple of questions, and if you have any questions with you, please write your question in the YouTube comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. And let's move on to the questions. The first question and important question is, what are all the console utilities in SSRS? If you really understand SSRS, there are some console utilities are there which supports in the backend for us. The first utility is rsconfig. Second utility is rsKeyManagement. Third utility is RS. RS is nothing but reporting services. Here the first utility is rsconfig. Second utility is RS. Third utility is rsKeyManagement. rsKeyManagement. So what it about? What is the purpose of these console utilities? We will talk about one by one. rsconfig. It is a configuration of connection properties between the report server to the repository database. It is a configuration of the connection properties between report server to the repository database. See here, if you really understand, you have components, report server and report databases. So this configuration file contains the connection properties between the report server and the repository database. Here, if you really install the SSRS on your machine, you will get a report server database and one report server as well. So to link between these two, we need to have one file. That file is utility is rsconfig. Configuration of connection properties between report server to the repository database. The next one is RS, reportserver.exe. And this is used for deploying the report on the report server. This is for the deployment. The next one is rsKeyManagement. There are some times where we may need to do some encryption as well. So that time this utility will help us. But on the whole, it is a management of encryption keys via command line. So this is the first one is for establish a connection between the report server and the repository database. And rs.exe, reportserver.exe, rs means, this will help us to do the deployments of the reports to the report server. Next, this is rsKeyManagement. rsKeyManagement is the one which helps us to do the encryption keys via command line. These are all about console utilities or command line utilities of SSRS. These three are very important in the backend to support us in the UI side. So as a developer, he might not be knowing in detail about these three utilities, but better to know these. Backend, these three will help us to do the deployment and do the encryption and to access the reports in the report manager. These are the major components in the backend, the command line. Maybe some of the people might be using rs.exe so to do the command line deployment. But most of the developers nowadays, they are using through the Visual Studio only. When I say Visual Studio, it is a SQL Server data tools only. So that's it about a console utilities or command line utilities of SSRS. Both are the same. So the next one is, can you define report rendering in SSRS? What is meant by report rendering? First of all, does SSRS supports report rendering? Yes, it supports. And can you define that? Exporting a report data with design into any format. Let us say I designed a table report. I want that output in the PDF format. Yes, I can give you in the PDF format. That is nothing but a report rendering. So exporting a report data with design to any format like a PDF or a Word, Excel, CSV or HTML. So this is nothing but a report rendering in SSRS. This is one of the important feature in SSRS. This will help us to export the data. I am defining it will help us to export the data in any format, in your required format. That is nothing but a rendering format. SSRS supports, you can export the data into Word, you can export the data into Excel, you can export into CSV, you can export into PDF, you can export into HTML. These are the list of formats supported by the SSRS. Next question. Can I create report snapshot in SSRS? Obviously, yes, you can create it. You can create the report snapshot in SSRS. The answer is yes, you can create the report snapshot in SSRS report manager. You may need to have a specific privileges to create a snapshot. So that all privileges prospect to, you need to take care of that. Next, what is meant by report snapshot? What is meant by report snapshot? So report snapshot means it is instance of a report for future reference at a particular point of time. Let us say, so I observed a data in a particular report, report 1. So I want to see the same data even tomorrow as well. So then my report number is 1, report 1. So I have observed a data which contains 10 records. I want to see the same data tomorrow and day after tomorrow as well. So I doubt my report data may vary. That is the reason why I am creating a snapshot. And I am creating a snapshot and keeping the report server itself. It means that whenever I access this report, I will be getting 10 records because report snapshot has been created in the server. So I am accessing the data from the report snapshot only. It means that data is freezed for this report. Even though original data varying, but as an end user, I am getting the same data because I freezed the data. I created a snapshot. So anyone access, if even not only mine, even some other people also access, they will get the old data only because data is freezed, because it has been saved in the server with a snapshot for further references or future references. So even though irrespective of data varies or not in the backend, I will be getting the same data until I cancel the snapshot. So that's it about a report snapshot. And this is one of the important feature in SSRS. So you can create a how many snapshot you want based on the privileges you have. As a normal user, as a browser privilege, you may not be able to create, but you need to have a specific privileges to handle with a report snapshot. The next one is, what is a query parameter in SSRS? This is one of the important interview question in SSRS. Then what is a query parameter? The parameters which we handle in the queries, directly I am talking about the query, the parameters which we directly handle in the queries is nothing but a query parameters. Let us say there is a data set which contains a query, select star from, I'm simply writing select star from EMP where DEPT ID equal to @DEPT ID. So if you really see this, this is a data set query which I have written in the data set. Now this is a, if you see this, I created a parameter earlier and I used that parameter in the data set query. If you really understand clearly, so I have used the parameter in the data set query, then I can call it as a query parameters. The parameters if you use in the query, that is nothing but a query parameters. Let me define. Query parameters are the one which we mention in the query of the data sources that are to be included into the SQL script, where clause or wherever it is. And even like it, the param, while creating a parameter, you should follow some standards. So the parameter name should not contain spaces and all. So the query parameter is the one which will use in the queries directly in the data sets. So is there any other way rather than going with the query parameters? Yes, you can go even other way as well. Let us say you created a stored browser. So that time your stored browser needs some parameters. So those parameters, so we will be keeping in the data set properties, not directly in the data set. So that is nothing but a different way. That is not query parameters. Query parameters are one. We have a SQL query in the data set, direct SQL query. In that query, we are making use of the parameters. That is nothing but a query parameters. So that's it about a query parameters in SSRS. It's a very common task for a couple of reports. May not be daily we are using this, but it is a quite common event we will be using for a couple of scenarios in a basic reports of SSRS. So that's all about this video. In the next video, I'll try to cover some more important interview questions. So we talked about what is the query parameters in SSRS, what is a snapshot, can I create a report snapshot in SSRS, can you define report rendering in SSRS, and what are the console utilities or command line utilities. Apart from that, in the previous video, I talked about these questions. What is your confidence level? Can I embed SSRS reports? What is SSRS? What is meant by data region? What are different types of data regions? Can you please explain about subreport? These are the questions I talked about in the previous video. So not only these, if you have any questions in SSRS or MSBI or SQL or Power BI, please write your questions in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe for more technical updates. That's it. Thank you for watching.